गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर गुड स्टूडेंट्स. यू नो वी हैव डन द चैप्टर नंबर 4, सो टुडे वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग द चैप्टर नंबर 5 ऑफ इंग्लिश, दैट इज द फार्मर, हिज सन एंड द डोंकी. स्टूडेंट्स, ओपन योर इंग्लिश बुक एंड यू हैव टू रीड इट अलॉन्ग विद मी. टुडे वी विल बी डूइंग द रीडिंग एंड आई विल बी एक्सप्लेनिंग यू साइड बाई साइड. लेट स्टार्ट. This story is written by Aesop. As you can see in the red color, the spelling is written A-E-S-O-P. Aesop is the writer who has written this story, The Farmer, His Son and the Donkey. Let's start. Have you ever read a story with a moral? They are asking us, have you ever read a story with a moral? So yes, we have read so many stories. They are having the moral also. But what is a moral, students? A moral is a lesson that we learn through the story. A moral is something good that you are learning from the story. That is the moral. Aesop's Fables is a collection of stories with morals. Read this story from the collection. So, Aesop's Fables means, students, fable is a story about an animal. If a story is about an animal, you will say that it is a fable. And Aesop's Fables means that Aesop has written this fable. So, let's start the reading. Understand it very carefully, students. One day, a farmer and his son were going to the market with their donkey to sell it. The donkey plodded on in front, while the farmer and his son walked behind. Students, as you can see in the picture also, in this story, the main three characters are the farmer, his son, and the donkey. So, the farmer, his son, they were going to the market. Why they were going, students? To sell their donkey. Donkey is an animal. So, the farmer and his son were going to the market to sell their donkey. The donkey plodded on in front, while the farmer and his son walked behind. It means that donkey was walking slowly in front, while the farmer and his son were walking behind. Firstly, donkey was walking, and after that, the farmer and his son, they were following. They were moving behind the donkey. Come to the next paragraph. They had gone just a short distance when a woman called out to them. So now they have just covered this very short distance, but a woman called out. A woman was calling to them. Why are you both walking? Your son could ride on the donkey. The farmer told his son to get on the donkey and they went on their way. So why that woman called, students? Woman said, why are you both walking? Your son could ride on the donkey. Woman was saying that you are having an animal and he is walking, so your son could ride on the donkey. It means that your son could sit on the donkey and then you can go. So what the farmer did, students? The farmer told his son to get on the donkey and then they went on their way. So now, after this, the son was sitting on the donkey while the father was walking. Next paragraph. When they had walked a little further, some old men shouted to them. Why is that young boy riding while his father walking? It's horrible. Young people are not thoughtful nowadays. So now, who came across, students? An old man. Old man shouted to them. What he said? He said, why is that young boy riding while his father walking? That why his son is sitting on the donkey? He is a young boy. He can walk. But the father is an old man. He should ride on the donkey and son should walk. This was said by an old man. It's horrible. Horrible means bad. It's horrible. It's bad that son is sitting on the donkey and father is walking. Young people are not thoughtful nowadays. This line is for the son. Who is young, students? the son or the farmer, obvious it is, the son is young people. It counts in the young people. So he is a young boy and he is not thinking that my father is walking and I am riding. So that's bad. Quickly the farmer told his son to get down and he climbed on the donkey. Now quickly, what the farmer did? Farmer told his son to get down and he climbed on the donkey. Now farmer was riding and son was walking. They had not been going for very long when two old women shouted at them, "Look at that selfish farmer on the donkey, while his poor son trails behind." Now again, see students, firstly a woman came across, then an old man. Now again, two old women shouted at them when they were going to the market. Again, now two old women came across and they shouted at them. They said, "Look at that selfish farmer." Selfish farmer, it means that who is thinking about himself only. He is riding and his poor son. Poor son because he is a small boy. That's why they said poor son. He is just walking, coming behind. And the farmer, that selfish farmer, is riding. Poor son trails behind. Trails means, student, that walking with heavy footsteps. As if he is tired. Because he is a small boy like you. Yes. That's why he was feeling very tired and he was walking with very heavy footsteps. That's why two old women said, selfish farmer and poor son. That's why they used this word, selfish farmer, who was thinking about himself only. He was riding on the donkey and the poor son trails behind. Poor son was coming with heavy footsteps. Sighing, the farmer told his son to get up behind him. And they went on their way. Now what the farmer did, students? Sighing, taking a very deep breath. Sighing means taking a long breath, a deep breath. Farmer told his son to get up and sit behind him. And they went on their way. Now as you can see in the picture, no. What they did? Farmer was sitting in front and the son also sat on the donkey. And then they went on their way. A little further along the road, they met a gang of boys. The boys made fun of the farmer and his son. So now see, students, fourth time that someone is coming across the farmer and his son. It's very funny also that they were going to the market and the fourth time that someone is stopping them and commenting something. So now who was the fourth one? A gang of boys. They made fun of the farmer and his son. Gang of boys means a group of boys. Look at you. Come on the next page, students. Look at you, monsters. You are making the poor donkey carry such a heavy burden. You should carry the donkey, they said. Now they said, look at you, monsters. Monster means cruel persons who don't care about the feeling of others. So they said to the farmer and the son that look at you, monsters. They were mentioning the farmer and his son as monsters. You are making the poor donkey carry such a heavy burden. Because donkey is a very big animal. Yes, students, he is having much weight. That's why they said that you are sitting on the donkey and you are he is carrying heavy burden. So you should carry the donkey. Because they said them cruel also, and now they said, poor donkey is carrying you the heavy burden, now you should carry the donkey. This was said by a gang of boys. Now the farmer made the donkey lie down. Lie down means to come down. Now he was not riding on the donkey. Farmer come down from the donkey. Then he tied the animal's feet together. He got a long pole, put it between the donkey's legs, and he and his son carried the donkey upside down. Now they tied the animal's feet, means donkey's feet, together with a rope, and also they used a pole between the legs. And what they did now, students? Now they were not sitting on the donkey, but they were carrying the donkey upside down. They were now holding the donkey. Donkey was not moving on his feet. Now the farmer and his son, they were carrying the donkey. The donkey was heavy as they came to a bridge. The farmer stumbled and fell. Students, the donkey was a very heavy animal as farmer and the son were carrying him. So farmer stumbled when they came to a bridge. Stumbled means that he lost his balance while walking and he fell. He fell on the bridge because he lost his balance. The donkey slipped into the river and soon he drowned. The donkey slipped into the river because he was carried by the farmer and his son, and farmer fell, so the donkey also slipped into the river and soon he drowned. Drowned means when somebody died just because when he fallen down into the water, into a river. As you can see in the picture also, donkey is drowned into the river and he could not even take the breath also. That's why he died. Farmer fell on the bridge. This is a bridge, a brown color. Donkey is in the river and he drowned. The farmer said sadly, "From now on, I will make up my own mind about the right thing to do. You can't please all the people all the time." So students, now farmer said he was very sad because he was going to the market, but when he came to the bridge, his donkey drowned. He died into the river. And that's why he was sad. And he said, farmer was saying now that I will make up my own mind, that I will take my decisions myself. I will not listen to the others because I cannot make everyone happy. Yes, students, in the whole world, we cannot listen to everyone. We cannot make everyone happy. We have to take our own decisions. We have to take the right thing, what we have to do. So this was said by farmer that I will make up my own mind. I will choose, I will decide. I will take the decision myself, what I have to do. You can't please all the people all the time, that we cannot make everyone happy all the time. So students, this was your lesson, the farmer, his son and the donkey. And what was the moral of this lesson, students? That we have to take the decision ourselves. Think yourself what you have to do and then take the right decision. I hope the chapter is clear to you, students. Thank you. For any doubt, you can call me. Read it 4-5 times and understand it very nicely. Thank you, students.